You and I had talked about, and we, Max Heine and I, wrote about the efforts that have sort of been ongoing to sort of test the idea of a kind of national approach to appeals. But before we get into a little bit more of that, I wanted to ask Chris Haney, have you gotten to a place with a lot of data queues where you've had to file an official appeal? And if so, like how do you get, how have you gotten through those?
No.
Okay.
No.
You haven't.
And I know, and Todd, I have to laugh because when we were going through the interview and you had asked me about my success record, and I had so innocently and wasn't even thinking about it, and I said that I had a perfect record, which I do, but now that it's out there, I feel like I just whomped myself.
Yeah, you're cursed
So,
now.
I mean, I
Nice.
know, but no, I have been fortunate.
Okay.
All of those that I have done, I have not had to appeal. So all I can offer are stories from colleagues,
Right. Well,
and frustration generally, and usually after they explain what the issues were, it's pretty recognizable that during the appeal process, they were more interested in expressing their feelings about it than they were about arguing whatever their actual legal
arguing the actual
position
case.
was.
Yeah. Yeah. I've heard
So
that from a lot
less
of folks.
feelings, yeah,
Yeah.
less feelings and stick to those facts.
Right. We've got what we mean by when I say appeals, just to clarify, we're talking about, you submit a data queue, you're asking
Right.
to for a violation to be removed, and the state comes back with a final decision. And then you, like Chris Turner said earlier, you hit that reply again and you ask for either a supervisory review or somebody in the training department to look, take another look. And in some cases, the state of Minnesota, as any of our regular readers may know from our coverage of this in that Setting the Record Straight series, in some cases, there are panels that do involve industry folks that are tasked with reviewing the really hard to handle data queues cases where, there's a question there that just can't be resolved to the satisfaction of the carrier and or driver, as the case may be, and requires a more in-depth review. And Chris Turner, tell us a little bit about the effort that CVSA is undertaking to kind of test out an idea to take that sort of appeals panel idea and take it to a larger scale on a national basis.
Absolutely. So, I was going to use a different example, but this will work. So behind me, you see the law books up there. So those aren't the federal regulations, but they might as well be. So, we're talking about books that are pretty thick, the font's small, and there's a lot of pages. And none of us, no matter how good we are, can be absolute experts on every part of the federal motor carrier safety regulations. It just can't do it. So CVSA, and first of all, FMCSA recognized that there are improvements to be made in the data queue system. And then as part of their high priority notice of funding opportunities, they asked for innovative ideas that may help with data queues, requests for data review, and or a data queue appeals process on a national level. So CVSA last year proposed a different appeals process to FMCSA. We weren't awarded the opportunity to move forward, but what we were awarded from FMCSA was the opportunity to flesh that out more, to explore that, to have some meetings. Let's see where we're at. So CVSA in this next round of high priority grants from FMCSA is going to try again. And our goal is to establish a panel at a national level. And we'll start with the demonstration project to make sure we do our best to get the kinks worked out and try and avoid unforeseen consequences with two or three member states. And the idea is that as they have those carrier appeals, that not the first appeal, because that would go back to the state to hopefully a management level where the state could take another look at it from the carrier's point of view and decide. And if there's still yet another appeal, so your second appeal or basically your third challenge, it would come to CVSA through the data queue system. I require FMCSA to make some changes in the system because one of the things we don't know is exactly how many are appealed. We do know,
Right.
because it's just a reply on an email button,
Yep.
right? So we need to change a little functionality in the system. FMCSA has at least been open to that idea. Hopefully we wrote a good enough grant that they believe in what we're trying to do. And we want to incorporate law enforcement. So our idea right now is a 7-person panel. That would be 4 law enforcement officers, carrier, and then 3 from industry is right now what we're talking about. And that would include a driver, a carrier representative, you know, whether it's members of our association, a group of associates or ATA or OIDA, you know, who that is yet to be determined, but it's critical we have that carrier point of view, you know, that we have someone like Chris who says, okay, hey, this is where the carrier is coming from. This is what they're seeing. This is what they're looking at. And then as necessary, we'll bring in subject matter experts. You know, if it is one of those harder parts of the federal regulations, whether it's hazardous materials and a labeling requirement on a battery that requires the package to be marked, but it doesn't have to be placarded on the truck, you know, one of those harder type of situations. And then they'll vet it. That group will make a decision and provide a recommendation back to the state. And then the agreement with those participating states is that they will change it based on this panel's recommendation about how that should go. So it'll be a little bit more time consuming once we're fleshed out, meaning that it will have to have that second appeal. So going back to the best practices for the carrier, if you get denied, I believe you're right, you'll want to appeal quickly, you know, to help resolve that process. And then once it does get to us, we'll take that look at it and provide that best recommendation back to the state. We're excited about the opportunity. We know this has been longstanding, you know, reading your article, industry out there says it's time to do something different. And a national data accuser panel had greater than, you know, 50%. I think there's a lot of support out there for it, and we want to see if we can really make a difference. And again, get to the corrected data. That's what we want.
Anything that more involves industry and industry representatives, drivers, the trucking company representatives. Yes, I think that would go a long way towards developing that relationship so that there's a little bit more trust if we can say that we have some input involved in this. Because right now, as an industry, it's more, we just feel more like a victim of the process rather than a part of the process. And right. We've talked about this before. We touched on it a little bit in the beginning about what the perception is. There are bad actors out there. Yes, there are, but it is such a small percentage of drivers and carriers, but yet we're all judged as an industry on the actions of those few. And actually that works both ways. It's just frustrating on our part that we don't feel like we have involvement. So yes, anything that involves a panel that includes industry representatives that are actually participating and contributing, not just a figurehead or just somebody to put on a bumper sticker.